Good morning, everybody, and welcome to our service from the study. This is we're pre-recording this one, as we have been doing every month for the last period. And just to say, you're welcome, and you can message in, and we'll pick the message up and respond to you at some point, but not live during the service. And just to say, this is the last one of these. It's quite a moment. The last one of these we're doing from the study.
On a Wednesday morning,
I hasten to add. Very key to remember that. What we're going to do on the Wednesday morning services as we go forward, we're going to go to St. Andrew's, back to St. Andrew's, and once a month on the second Sunday and second Wednesday of the month, we're going to attempt to live stream. We're going to live stream. That's the communion service from there. I know many people have joined in on a Wednesday morning, but we were finding in terms of the resource that we have, it became more difficult to continue to do. And also more people were being out on a Wednesday morning. And so what we're going to do is we'll go into the building every Wednesday from September, from next week. And on the second Wednesday of the month, we'll stream the communion service. But we will continue to stream services either from the building or from the study every Sunday as we move forward. That's part of what we feel that we're being called to as part of our ministry as we move forward. It feels something that we're significantly being called to do. So thank you so much. We'd like to say for that for joining us. Helen's getting our Wednesday mornings back. when you think about how long we have been here doing this, and how many, I wonder if you've worked out how I organise my books yet. I'd like to know. By looking at the pack in the pictures, so it would be lovely.
Not very well.
Just to let you know, this coming Sunday, the last Sunday of the month, we have a service online at 9:30, and then at 11 o'clock we have a service in St. Andrew's Church, and then we also have a service at St. Nicholas at 6:30 on Sunday evening coming up. Just a reminder, for the last Sunday and next Sunday, for the next couple of Sundays, the radio show has just been put on pause, only because Paul's on holiday and I've no idea how to make the technology work. No other reason. We're going to continue with the radio. I know a lot of people really appreciate that, and that's very much part of what we're thinking about as our ministry going forward. But as always, do be in touch if you've got anything that you'd like to hear or share.
Absolutely.
Just like to say particular thanks to Helen, because for all of the stuff that you've done, and I think I probably could have put that a bit more eloquently. Thank you for all of the contribution, because one of the things is that it's been
an absolute joy and a pleasure to participate on a Wednesday morning, to work alongside you. And
just huge thank you to David for enabling this to happen as well. But, you know, we continue to worship. We continue to do all of the things that we feel that's really significant and important to do. So wherever you are this morning, welcome. You're welcome to join us. And we ask that God would just move amongst us wherever we are, whether we're watching live or whether we're watching later or whenever we're watching, that God would move among us and that we would know his power and his presence with us, we pray.
Absolutely. Amen.
I'm going to lead us through the opening part of the service today. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Lord, we've heard the good news of the life, death, and resurrection of your Son. We've come to experience his power, to hear your call, and to be sent out as disciples of Christ. Lord, so fill our thoughts, our lives, and our lips with songs of praise that others may long to bring glory to you. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is the only Lord, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. And God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins and to be our advocate in heaven and to bring us eternal life. So knowing that, all that Christ has done for us, we're going to say sorry for the things that we've got wrong. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Knowing we're forgiven, we respond with these wonderful words of praise in the words of the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. So is what we've often done. We've often used a psalm as part of our worship on when we've been in the study, and we're going to finish.
We're going to finish with a
psalm today.
Yeah, a psalm. Oh, yeah. Which is Psalm 126.
Yeah.
When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter, and our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, Lord, like streams in the Negev. Those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy. Those who go out weeping, carrying seed to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Bless you.
Sorry.
This is one of those Psalms of Ascent, which we've talked about starting from Psalm 121 through to Psalm 135. And these were psalms that the people of Israel, and songs and prayers, the people of Israel would have spoken as they were heading towards the temple to worship. Mm-hmm. And so they were often, so the whole variety, but what they're often, they're a reminder of the goodness of God, and they're almost like a retelling of accounts of the faithfulness of God. Mm. And I was struck as I was thinking about this psalm, is this whole idea, there's quite a bit about joy in there. The Lord has done great things for us, the middle verse, and we are filled with joy, and a recollection of the Lord has done great things. But there's also, in this psalm, there's talk of tears and weeping. Yeah. As well as joy. And our relationship with God, the joy that we find, is not the absence of the weeping in some ways. Does that make sense? There is something that's beyond that. So we know that part of the world that we live in, that the brokenness and the way that, you know, we've gone away from what God has wanted us to do, that there is stuff that brings weeping and laments. But within that, there is joy. They're not mutually exclusive. That's one of the things I really get from this psalm. You know, there's laughter, there's joy, but there's also weeping, and there's tears. That's a part of it, and they're all a part of our relationship with God, aren't they? We bring them all to that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
yeah.
You've got any?
I mean, I am. The bit that really spoke to me was the restore our fortunes, Lord, like the streams in the Negev. And that was talking about that parts of Judea are really quite dry.
So the Negev
barren.
is like a river. It's a river, yeah, okay.
And parts of Judea were very dry and barren. But then when the rains came in the distance to the higher mountains, in the autumn, it would flood. There'd be flash floods, and things would suddenly become very wet, and the river would just become a river really quickly, from almost out of nowhere, with a mighty flow, it says.
Yeah.
And it's, if you can imagine that, a dry desert where nothing's growing, suddenly becoming full of water and life. So when I lived in, lived and worked in Thailand, obviously you have the rainy season, you have the hot season, the dry season, and the dry season comes April, and then the rainy season starts to follow. And everything is very dry. It's there's no grass. It's all powdery. The soil is all powdery. And the paddy fields are completely empty. They're just, it looks like dried mud. There's cracks. Mm-hmm. It's really dry. And then the rains come. And when they come, boy, they come. And they fill everything up. And within days of them filling up, there is green everywhere. Mm. Everywhere is green. And there are little shoots and little flowers that you just think, where did you come from? There was nothing there. It was completely dry and dead. And the most exciting thing, I think, that I found was that after about a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks maybe, the guys would go out and they'd start fishing in the paddy fields with their nets. And you're thinking, what do you mean? It's an enclosed piece of land. And they're fishing, and they were fishing for fish, and they caught fish because there is a fish there that lays its eggs somehow dormant in the mud, and it dries out. And then when the water comes, that's when they hatch and become fish, and then they can catch them and eat them. And it's astounding, isn't it? But what water brings, that rush of water, and for me, that's...
So... Yeah, that's like God's power coming. And there's the moment there. I was really struck as you were speaking there, Helen. It says that restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the streams in the Negev. So there's almost like there's an acknowledgement in their journey as they're ascending to worship that there are times of dryness and barrenness.
Yeah.
And they're saying, Lord, restore us and come in your, you know, let us know, restore our the places where we feel dry.
Yeah.
The places where we feel, and I don't know about you, there have been times in the last 18 months where it has felt quite dry. There have been times where it's felt quite difficult. You know, we need to be honest, don't we? We need to be honest. You know, we have faith. We know God's goodness. We know his joy. But there are times when the stuff that's going on around us is difficult. And actually, I say the last 18 months. I think that's true for all of our lives. There are times when things are really difficult. Yeah, I guess what we cry out for is that, Lord, that we would know something of your joy and something of that restoration that comes like the streams in the desert, you know, that streams in the Negev. Yeah.
Mm.
And because
absolutely. And I think for me, when I was thinking about the fish coming out of the paddy fields, is that sometimes we can look at our lives and we can think there's nothing there.
It's all gone.
My faith is all gone. There's a Keith Green song that talks about, oh Lord, please light the fire that once burned bright within. And sometimes our faith can just seem like it's not there. But actually,
it feels like we're going through the
God's,
motions.
As God restores, like the streams,
store our fortunes.
Our faith reignites. And if you're in that dry place at the moment, if you're feeling dry and that your light is really dim, and we haven't lit the candle yet,
we'll do that
in a minute thing. but just think that it is still that God still loves you. God has done great things for us, and we can be filled with joy.
And the psalmist goes on to say, those who sow in tears will reap with songs of joy. It's not that we have to say, oh, hang on, I can't be sad. That doesn't say that. It doesn't say, you know, if you want songs of joy, stop crying. It's not saying that. That actually the psalmist says that when God, if we allow ourselves to be open to when God comes, he can turn those tears into songs of joy. Those who go about weeping, carrying seed to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with him. God is faithful. God is faithful. And it's not, you know, sometimes we can beat ourselves up and go, hang on, you know, as a Christian, I shouldn't be finding it difficult or challenging. And, you know, sometimes people say that, you know, you just got to believe a little bit more. But the psalmist doesn't say that. Says that that's just part weak. Of course, we have to continue to believe. But believing isn't like a magic switch that switches all of it on and takes away our sadness and takes away our lament and takes away our grief. That's not how it works. But it is that we continue to trust in God in that moment. And we sow with tears and we come back with sheaves of joy.
Yeah.
So there's a place where in the midst of it, we continue to turn to God. And it's not a magic switch that all of a sudden makes it right. There is a place where we continue to come to God. You know, they could be in that moment with that dry bit, and they could be desperately longing. They could be desperately longing, saying, we really want the water, we really want the water. However much they really wanted the water, that water wasn't going to come. That water was going to come when it comes. And that is, we need to be aware of that with God, don't we? We need to be aware of God's grace that is always for us. And sometimes we just need to be ready to receive that. Yeah, it's an interesting time. I love the Psalms of Ascent. I love the fact that they were put together as a kind of like part of their worship and praise as they process, as they head up towards the temple, as a continual reminder of the goodness of God to them, mm-hmm. and that God is always with them. Mm-hmm. Wonder what your thoughts are. Now, we're not live, but you can email me in if you've got any questions, if you've got any thoughts as we head forward. Please don't hesitate to do that. And my email address is on the screen. Anything to conclude, Helen? You're going to light the candle?
No, but I am going to light the candle, because I think if you are in that place at the moment where you feel your light has gone out or you're very dry, you are not alone, but please be in touch.
Yeah.
And people can pray with you. We can walk alongside you in that journey.
Those who sow in tears will reap with songs of joy.
Yeah.
Something very powerful. We're going to sing a wonderful modern reworking of the fantastic hymn Amazing Grace now. Thanks, David. Unending love, amazing grace. God is unchanging. Let us affirm our faith in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. We say together, Though he was divine, he did not cling to equality with God, but made himself nothing. Taking the form of a slave, he was born in human likeness. He humbled himself to obedient to death, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God has raised him on high and given him the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow and every voice proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Helen's now going to lead us in our time of intercession.
Let's pray. And our response today, when I say Lord of Lords, we say together, hear us, we pray. Lord of Lords,
hear us, we pray.
Our Heavenly Father guides us faithfully and enlightens our lives. So let us pray now to him for the church, the world, and the place that we live here in Old Felixstowe. We pray that we may be ready to follow Christ wherever he leads us, even if the direction is unexpected or demanding. Lord of Lords,
hear us, we pray.
We pray that all nations may rejoice in the light of goodness and reject the darkness of evil. Lord of Lords,
hear us, we pray.
We pray that in the brightness of love, Christ may be revealed, turning the doubtful to faith, the despairing to hope, the revengeful to forgiveness, and those who feel dry and empty to fullness of life. Lord of Lords,
hear us, we pray.
We pray that no opportunity may be lost in sharing the joy and the peace of Jesus with those who we meet in our daily lives, whether that be at work, online, whether that be in the supermarket, our neighbours, on the phone to our family and friends. Lord of Lords,
hear us, we pray.
And now in the silence, we lift our prayers to the Lord for our own needs and cares and those who God has laid on our hearts. Father, we commend our lives to your loving care through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of God's peace. Peace be with you. The Lord be with you. And also with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
For it is right to give thanks and praise.
You are worthy of our thanks and praise, Lord God of truth, for by the breath of your mouth you have spoken your word, and all things have come into being. You fashioned us in your image and placed us in your garden of delight. Though we chose the path of rebellion, you would not abandon your own. Again and again you drew us into your covenant of grace. You gave your people the law and taught us by your prophets to look for your reign of justice, mercy, and peace. And as we watch for the signs of your kingdom on earth, we echo the song of angels in heaven, evermore praising you and saying, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord God, You are the most holy one, enthroned in splendor and light, yet in the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, you reveal the power of your love made perfect in our human weakness.
Amen.
Lord, we believe. Embracing our humanity, Jesus showed us the way of salvation, loving us to the end. He gave himself to death for us, dying for his own. He set us free from the bonds of sin that we might rise and reign with him in glory.
Amen.
Lord, we believe. On the night that he gave himself up for us all, he took bread and he gave you thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Amen.
Lord, we believe.
In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and he gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Amen.
Lord, we believe.
Therefore, we proclaim the death that he suffered on the cross. We celebrate his resurrection, his bursting from the tomb. We rejoice that he reigns at your right hand on high, and we long for his coming in glory. Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus.
And as we recall the one perfect sacrifice of our redemption, Father, by your Holy Spirit, let the gifts of your creation be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Form us into the likeness of Christ and make us a perfect offering in your sight. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Look with favour on your people and in your mercy hear the cry of our hearts. Bless the earth, heal the sick, and let the oppressed go free. And Lord, fill your church with power from on high. Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Gather your people from the ends of the earth to feast with all your saints at the table in your kingdom, where the new creation is brought to perfection in Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. And as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the whole world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed.
Lord Jesus Christ, since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I pray you would come spiritually to my soul. Come, Lord Jesus, come and cleanse me, heal me, strengthen me and unite me with you, now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ given for us all.
Amen.
God of all mercy, in this Eucharist you have set aside our sins and given us your healing. Grant that we, who are made whole in Christ, may bring that healing to this broken world. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Peace. in the name of Christ.
Amen. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, as we said, this is the last one from the study on a Wednesday, depending on circumstances, depending if anything changes. Please do be in touch. We will review it as we go forward. As always, we are always open to what it is. Please look at our website, look at the details on our website. Please do be in touch if you've got any questions. And as I say, particularly at that moment, you know, really struck by this whole concept that, you know, you might be feeling really dry, and as Helen said, ask someone to journey with you and to pray with you.
Yeah.
And one of the things to look out for is coming the next week or so. The newsletter will be coming out, not this week, next week, 2 weeks' time even. Look out for information about small groups and, you know, groups that can work and journey alongside you and learn together and support each other. Please do have a look out for those groups. And if you'd like to be involved in any of those, if you'd like to be involved possibly in hosting or leading, please do be in touch, and we'll sort of see if we can what we can do on that sort of score as we move forward. Really important that we journey with each other, isn't it?
Yeah,
fellowship is really important. Okay, I would like to say have a lovely rest of the week. God bless, and I'll see you on Sunday. Take care. Bye-bye.